In this video, we will show how to find the suffix code on your Panasonic main board. Some boards do not have a suffix code, so just be sure to look over your board and look for the suffix grid on your board. Here's an example of what the suffix grid looks like that will be explained in this video. If you are looking for help with your Panasonic main board in the suffix grid, and your suffix grid looks different than the one shown here, please click the link that we have provided, and that will take you to another video that we have made for a different style of suffix grid on a Panasonic main board. If your suffix grid looks like the one shown here in the video, then please continue watching to find out more information. Once you have decided that you should replace your main board to repair your TV, if you haven't already, you will want to carefully remove the screws on the back of your TV, remove the back cover, and then remove the main board from the chassis. Typically, when removing the main board, you will need to disconnect a few cables and then remove some screws that connect the board to the chassis. When looking over the main board in your Panasonic TV, you will want to identify the part number on your board and the suffix code on your board. This area will provide a two-letter suffix code for your part number. Both of these pieces of information are important to find the correct replacement part for your TV. In the suffix area, you will see areas with letters and also with solder points. Right here are the letters, and then here are the solder points. The connected solder points provide the key to identifying your suffix code. Some suffix codes are broken down into the upper half and the lower half. You can see they are labeled here on the board. The upper half will always represent the first letter in the suffix code, and the lower half will always represent the second letter in the suffix code. We have added some shading to this photo to help clarify things. On this board, the connected solder points represent the letter U in the upper half and the letter B in the lower half. The solder points can be read from side to side or top to bottom. Connecting two solder points up and down will match the section with the two letters. Connecting solder points side to side will match the section with the three letters. We will now go over which letter matches which connected solder points. On the upper half, we have G, H, A, B, C, J, K, D, E, F, L, M. Having just explained the one section of the upper half of the suffix grid, that pattern and the solder points and the letters, that will hold true for both sections of the upper half, the solder points that match up with the different letters. So the same solder points will match up with the other letters on the second half of the upper half. And then it will also hold true for both sections of the lower half as well. So you can just take the information that we provided here and then apply that to the other sections of the suffix grid as well. In order to find a compatible replacement main board, you will want to take your part number plus the suffix and search that info on our website, www.shopjimmy.com. Here's what a search looks like with just the part number and no suffix. You will see that we get many results with different suffixes for the same part number. Here's what the search looks like after I use the part number and the suffix. As you can see, we receive an identical replacement part. In this video, we have shown how to read a suffix grid on a Panasonic main board. Again, if this suffix grid looks different from the suffix grid on your Panasonic main board, please click the link here shown in the video, and you can watch another video that we made for a different style of suffix grid. Thank you for watching one of our many tutorials here at ShopJimmy.com. If you have any further questions regarding your repair, simply post a question in the comment section below or call our award-winning customer service team at the number on your screen. We strive to learn and share new TV repair tips every day. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and grow with us. Share our videos with your friends to help us spread the savings, and don't forget to hit that like button.